was the guy who opened the gates of export to us. We all know we were selling India before selling our company. And he did that job for all of us in 60s and 70s, and our job was much easier. We all in IT industry struggled hard in those days, but he was ahead of all of us. Building institution, we all know. I don't think I want to talk about TCS and how great it is. We all know. I think he has built an institution which we all like to emulate. In Mastek, of course, we always say what TCS will do and what are they doing. So that's always a discussion. And I'm sure many other places, which gave a lot of leaders. I think he has, as they say in IBM, generated leader for US industry IT. I can say that about TCS. And that's a great contribution. The CEOs that we have in 1980s when we founded NASSCOM used to say, "Arey, kahan se milenge a CEO or project manager if you want to become $1 billion?" That time billion was a big number. Now we are 190 billion. He is one of those who built those leaders. But beyond that, I think all of some of you are here. They would know he supported ecosystem around IT industry. CSI chairman, IEEE, and many other things he has supported, which were ecosystems around IT industry. So he had a vision of what we call ecosystem then.
For me, as a founder of a software company in the early 90s, Mr. Kohli was a Dronacharya guru for me. I was trying to emulate and learn from him and other such leaders. And he was actually very active and visible in NASSCOM, Computer Society of India, and IEEE. And the work of these pioneers was very important. They not only ran their own businesses, but they were also working together to build an industry for all of us. So it was their effort. They could have kept to themselves and worked on their own companies, but the fact that they worked with each other to build the industry was really very important for people like me who were following them many years later. He's a legend, and the work he did to get government and NASSCOM to formulate policies were the foundations for the success of the software industry, and that sets him apart as the father of the Indian software industry.
I invested very heavily in training in TCS, and also believed that research and development focus is fundamental, and started to build software tools in the early days when we were a very, very small company. He had a very, very strong desire about the hardware industry. Until recently, in all the conversations I've had with him, two things always figured. One is, what is the future of hardware and how India should take part and shape that.
Since TCS, the perception was that until, for a long time has been that TCS is largely a software engineering kind of practice. But don't forget that Mr. Kohli set up the first systems and engineering, system engineering and cybernetics center back in 1981 with Professor Murthy, which he nurtured further as well now. And then he also created the management consulting. And if in the early days, it was very clearly told to us that TCS is not IT company. It was a problem-solving company.
We did something very good in IT, but in hardware, we missed the bus. And he did try. He used to say that he went to the secretary, electronics, but they were telling that, "Oh, we have this and we have that. We don't require IBM, we don't require," and so on and so forth. And we missed the bus. It was Taiwan, it was South Korea who took over. India missed the bus. So let us reinvent ourselves in hardware as well. That's what he used to tell always.
I want to end saying that there was this movie Anand, where the last dialogue is "Anand mara nahi, Anand marte nahi." Kohli Saab is physically not with us. I finally took the courage to write a blog for him today, after 2-3 days. But his spirit, his teaching, he will never go out of our lives, and he has left a big agenda for us to fulfill. That would be the best tribute to him, is to continue to do the work. He shaped not just industry, but he shaped the nation, and he gave remote software development as a methodology, not only to Indians, but to East Europeans, the Filipinos, the Latin Americans. He's a world leader in that sense, and very privileged to have spent those 14 years, some of it with him.